Okay, think about this name, Ozzy Osbourne. You know, the legendary rocker, the Prince of Darkness, huge persona, right? But behind that image, he brought a really personal health battle into the spotlight, Parkinson's disease. So today we're gonna sort of unpack his story. We wanna look closely at his specific diagnosis, what it tells us about Parkinson's more broadly, and really pull out the key insights for you from the material we've gathered.
Absolutely. It's so important to look beyond just the headlines, especially with neurodegenerative conditions. When someone like Ozzy shares their journey, it sheds light on an illness that's often, you know, really misunderstood. It makes it much more human.
Definitely. So let's start with Ozzy's public announcement. It was back in 2020, right? On Good Morning America. That's where he confirmed he had this genetic form of Parkinson's. This wasn't out of the blue. It came after a pretty serious fall he had in 2019. That led to neck surgery, hospitalization. It was a big deal. For a lot of people, hearing that about Ozzy, it kind of shifted their perspective on him.
And it's really crucial here to clarify something about his passing. Ozzy passed away at 76. And while Parkinson's can definitely lead to complications, the cause of death was actually a heart attack. Coronary artery disease was also mentioned. So yes, Parkinson's was a huge part of his later life, but it wasn't the direct cause of death. That distinction is important.
That's a really vital point.
Meet Harper, a bright, curious young girl with autism. Harper doesn't just hear the world. She hears everything. Sometimes, sounds feel too loud. But what if that sensitive hearing was actually a superpower? When her neighbor's kitten goes missing, Harper discovers she can hear what others can't. I hear him. This way. Follow Harper's incredible journey, where being different becomes her greatest strength. My hearing is my superpower. A heartwarming tale of courage, kindness, and celebrating what makes us unique.
Okay, so let's zoom in on the diagnosis itself. This specific genetic type, PRKN, or PRKN2, it's linked to a gene mutation. So what makes this particular type, Parkinson's disease, different?
Well, the interesting thing about the PRKN gene mutation is that it's the most common cause of early onset Parkinson's. It's what we call a rare recessive form. So basically, you usually need to inherit two copies of that mutated gene, one from each parent, to develop the condition. And getting down to the cellular level, Parkinson gene, it's really closely tied to how mitochondria work.
Ah, the powerhouses of the cell. I remember that from biology class.
Exactly. They're fundamental for cellular energy. So a faulty Parkinson gene messes with that energy production.
So it's not just like a minor detail. If the PRKN mutation messes with the mitochondria, the cell's energy source, that's huge. It suggests Parkinson's isn't just about dopamine loss. Maybe it's a deeper energy problem in the cells themselves. That could, you know, open up different ideas for treatment eventually. And the stats we found mentioned PRK2 mutations are behind about, what, 15% of genetic cases?
Right, and around 4% of the more common early onset cases.
So yeah, while it's specific, it's definitely a significant piece of the puzzle for those groups. Okay, so understanding Ozzy's specific case with Parkin is fascinating. But how does this help us understand Parkinson's disease overall? Let's broaden the view a bit.
Sure. So Parkinson's, at its heart, is neurodegenerative. That means nerve cells in the brain gradually break down and, well, die over time. A lot of the symptoms we recognize, like the tremors or slowed movement, happen because we lose cells that produce dopamine.
Dopamine, the chemical messenger for movement and mood, right?
Exactly. Less dopamine means the brain's activity gets irregular. But it's not just dopamine. There's also a loss of norepinephrine. That's another key chemical messenger.
Okay, what does norepinephrine do?
It controls things like blood pressure, heart rate, other automatic functions. Its loss helps explain why some people with Parkinson's get dizzy when they stand up or have digestion issues. It's more than just the movement problems people usually think of.
That makes sense. It explains the wider range of symptoms. And speaking of symptoms, they really can vary, can't they? But you often see things like involuntary shaking, those tremors, usually starting in one hand. And then there's that slowed movement, bradykinesia, they call it. Makes simple daily tasks really hard.
Like buttoning a shirt or cutting food.
Yeah, exactly. Plus muscle stiffness, often in the arms or legs. Trouble with balance is a big one too, leading to falls. And even changes in speech, like it gets softer, or writing, where the handwriting gets smaller and smaller. It's quite profound when you think about it.
It really is, and the progression. It's different for everyone. Some people manage well for years with fairly mild symptoms. Others, unfortunately, might see a quicker decline. There's just no single predictable course for the disease.
That uncertainty must be incredibly difficult. And just to give everyone a sense of scale, Parkinson's affects over 1.1 million people in the U.S. That makes it the second most common neurodegenerative disease right behind Alzheimer's.
That's right. And around 90,000 new diagnoses happen each year in the U.S. alone.
Wow.
And here's something quite concerning from the data we looked at. Death rates linked to Parkinson's complications have jumped significantly, about 63% over the last couple of decades.
63%, that's a stark increase.
It is. It really highlights that while Parkinson's itself might not be the direct killer, its complications are having a much bigger impact on lifespan than maybe we previously thought. It's not just a motor disorder, it's systemic and life-limiting.
That really does change the perspective, which brings us to that really common and frankly quite scary question people have. Is Parkinson's fatal?
It's a tough question, and the answer is nuanced. Technically, Parkinson's disease itself isn't considered a fatal illness. But, and this is the critical part, people definitely can and do die from the complications arising from the disease.
Okay, so what are the main complications we're talking about?
The biggest one is lung problems.
Mm-hmm.
This comes from muscle weakness affecting the ability to cough properly and, very importantly, to swallow safely.
Right, swallowing issues.
Yeah.
And that leads to aspiration pneumonia.
Exactly. A federal study actually found that aspiration pneumonia accounts for something like 70% of deaths among Parkinson's patients.
70%? That's staggering.
It happens when food, saliva, or bacteria from the mouth get inhaled into the lungs instead of going down the esophagus.
It just shows how something that seems related to movement control can have these hidden, very serious consequences. So, okay, given all these challenges, what can actually be done? What are the approaches for managing Parkinson's? And how can we support people living with it?
Well, since there's no cure yet, treatment really focuses on managing the symptoms and trying to maintain the best possible quality of life. Medications are a cornerstone. They mostly work by increasing dopamine levels in the brain or mimicking dopamine's effects.
Okay.
For some people, especially in more advanced stages, surgery might be an option. Deep brain stimulation, or DBS, can help manage motor symptoms like tremors and stiffness.
Right, DBS, I've heard of that.
And then there are therapies. Physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, they're all incredibly important. They help with movement, flexibility, daily tasks, communication.
Makes sense. Keeping active sounds key.
Absolutely. Regular exercise, especially aerobic activity, can make a real difference for balance, mood, and just general well-being. And it's worth mentioning, as you pointed out with Ozzy, he was receiving stem cell treatments. That's still more experimental and replacing those lost dopamine cells, but it's an area of active research.
So a multifaceted approach seems best. Medication, maybe surgery, therapy, exercise. And for those of us wanting to support someone with Parkinson's, what are some practical things we can do?
Patience is number one. Really understanding that symptoms can change day to day, even hour to hour. Offering practical help is huge. Assisting with walking if they're unsteady, helping with dressing, maybe preparing meals, just easing those daily burdens.
Okay.
Encouraging them to stick with their therapies and exercise routines is also vital. And sometimes suggesting a support group can be really beneficial.
Connecting with others going through the same thing.
Exactly. Sharing experiences, tips, just knowing you're not alone, that can make a massive difference emotionally and practically.
So we've covered a lot today. We started with Ozzy Osbourne's personal story, his specific Parkin diagnosis. Then we broadened out to Parkinson's disease more generally, the genetics, the symptoms, both the obvious ones and the hidden ones, and finally, how it's managed and how we can offer support. It's clear that even though there isn't a cure right now, there are many ways to help manage the condition and, importantly, support the person living with it.
Definitely. And maybe a final thought to leave you with is this. Think about how understanding these specific genetic forms, like Parkin, could potentially lead to more personalized medicine down the road. Tailored treatments based on the specific type of Parkinson's someone has, and also how public figures speaking out, like Ozzy did, really does drive awareness, which in turn fuels research funding and strengthens support systems for everyone affected.
That's a hopeful perspective to end on, the power of understanding and awareness. We really hope this deep dive gave you some valuable insights into Parkinson's. Perhaps think about what part of this discussion resonated most with you, or maybe sparked a question you want to look into further.